I always imagined when I came here it would be to reclaim it.
It used to belong to Rosaria, didn't it?
Once, though it's been in the Ironblood's clutches for far too long.
As was I. For 13 years, this rock was my home. I know its secrets only too well. This path was abandoned after an ether flood. They don't guard it.
A perfect little shortcut. They're all the Kashyyyk.
The ether flood must have spread. It was never abandoned before. And the only way past them is through them. All the time. That wasn't even a bad one. It's nothing to worry about.
All right.
Look at this place. What a mess.
Wait. This one.
Press on?
Yes.
Inside the volcano. You get used to the heat. Though I don't remember it being quite this hot.
Was that one cause for concern?
It was. And they're getting bigger. Something's wrong.
Go for it!
Like these.
Over here!
I'm going this way.
Let's look for another path. Drake's breath.
We're nearly at the oratory.
What the hell is that? Well, whatever it is, I don't think it's friendly.
The lava.
If I didn't know better, I think this volcano was about to erupt.
Why attack us? They're peaceful creatures.
Then this one must be the exception.
Thank you.
Quite a commotion our friend made. Let's hope the guards didn't hear it.
The gate to the inner chambers is just up there. Then we make for the sanctuary. I need to finish this before the heat finishes me.
Hear, hear.
We'll enter the Comrick by the Handmaiden's living quarters. It was always a hive of activity.
Sounds like we'll have a hard time staying out of sight.
We won't have to. There's someone there I should very much like to see.
Lady Morley, it's me.
By the mother. Jill, it can't be.
It is, my lady.
We cannot talk here. Come with me.
I'm so glad you're safe.
And I you.
Why ever would you risk coming back? Are you a fool, girl? Or have you grown tired of your freedom already?
Forgive me, my lady. But I had to come back. There are things I left undone. Tell me, where is the Patriarch?
At this hour, he'll be in the Comrick, giving thanks.
You mean... Oh, fiend! Clive, we have to get to the Sanctuary. Now! Lady Morley, you must flee this place. Gather your things and go.
Now listen here, Jill.
In Elak, Lord!
We have company.
This way. Follow this passage. It leads straight to the Comrick. Go on, stop dawdling.
Thank you. You were always so kind to me. My light in the darkness. Take care, my lady, please. You deserve better than this. A long and happy life, promise me.
Promise to do the same.
Come on, Clive. We're nearly at the...
All right.
Is
our welcoming party.
I've had enough of their
hospitality. Over here!
How many of them are there?
Clive, there's something I need you to know. I saw the Patriarch do things no one should have to see. And so I swore that he would die by my hand.
I understand. I faced my demons, and you must face yours.
We're nearly there. Just one last push.
Attack!
Junon Gredith, O Mathen Sadov, Gladden 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 Junon Gredith.
Shiva's dominant. Come to beg forgiveness for your failure.
For years I followed your orders. Fought your wars. All to protect the children you took. Just as you took me. And what did you do in return? In chains, and you slit their throats!
Fiend.
Their souls were sullied with a stain of ether. I merely cleansed them of their corruption. A penance paid, just as the Holy Mother wills it! Repent, abomination! For a monster like you to set foot in the Holy Cymmrich is in itself a crime deserving of death.
You're right. I am a monster. And my soul is stained black. Though not by ether. But by the evil of men like you, who made me close my heart and drown in darkness when I should have raged against it. This is my penance. I will be your monster no more. Nor will I suffer you to create another.
Does the beast bare its teeth at its master? Come then, dominant. Rage, be as you have ever been. A monster!
And what are you, Imran? I was forced to kill. You do it by choice. But never again. I bowed to you once. Now it is you who shall bow to me.
Kill them.
her do it! Just once.
She won't be able to hold that half back forever. We better make this quick.
Take long.
Yeah.
Jill!
I'm going to finish this, Clive.
To it!
Oh. We destroyed it.
What? But... Monster! Monster! Do you have any idea what you have done?
I do, Father.
I have killed the monster! And become an outlaw!
May the blessing of the crystals go with you.
It's over.
It is.
And Shiva exacted her price.
She did.
Again, the burden fell to you.
And I bore it willingly. This was a sin for which I had to atone. Now I can continue at your side with my head held high. Clive, look.
It's just like the one at Phoenix Gate. Damn it. We need to leave.
Agreed.
Now you keep yours.
This way, Your Grace.
You're bleeding. I have a tonic which will...
I thank you for your kindness, truly. But I assure you, I will survive. Please, save your medicines for those who need them most.
Oh, well, if you're sure...
For a moment there, I felt my brother's presence.
You did?
I fear he is in Ultima's thoughts again. But why now, after 5 years of silence? I cannot keep him sealed away much longer.
Your Grace.
No, do not dirty your hands. Look at them all. Like a river flowing to the sea.
Or moths to a flame, perhaps. The crystalline dominion, their light in the darkness. More and more lose their homes to the blight and set out in search of sanctuary. While others lose their fortunes to the Dalmechian levies and leave to find new livelihoods. What is it that you seek in the Dominion, Your Grace?
Oh, Dion Lesage.
You mean the Crown Prince of Sanbrec?
He has many titles. Dion the Bold, Prince of Dragoons, Odin's Nemesis, or simply Bahamut. I met him once when we were children. He was a chivalrous soul even then, and has served his empire indefatigably ever since.
And you are confident that he will listen to what you have to say?
Our world lurches ever closer to the abyss, and a hidden hand ushers us onward. Ultima's influence extends to every nation, Sanbrec included. If His Highness is the man I believe him to be, and I pray that he is, this truth will not have escaped his notice. As the mother crystals fall, the eternal flame wavers, and the azure sky begins to bruise. How lucky we were to be blessed by the crystals. And yet, how spoiled. Like canaries in a gilded cage, growing fat on seed. But now, the bars are closing in, and we must take flight. Painful though it be to leave our home behind, it is what we must do to be free. Which is it that men cannot live without? A blessing that leads to damnation, or a freedom that leads to deprivation? I do not yet know the answer to that question. Do you, Clive?
Your Grace, let us find a place to rest a while. We can return by the Dalmechian Trail once you have recovered your strength. I realize your duty is pressing, but if your health should fail...
I know. Thank you, Yota.
army's attempt to breach the Empire's defenses and gain the Isles of Ark has failed yet again.
Only because your fleet has proved as impotent as a eunuch on Lane Night. Would you rather we simply fell back to the capital?
Enough, both of you. All here agree that the Empire cannot be allowed to maintain its illegitimate claim on the Dominion. However, our casualties mount with each passing day.
There is a literal sea twixt you and your prize. The armies of Sambrek need but sit back and watch as you harmlessly lap against their walls. They are dug in like ticks and seek to draw out this siege, knowing the capital's stores are nigh bottomless. And what of our wise rulers? Goaded into war without any thought as to what chaos it might reap. Republican soldiers starve while waiting for orders from Randalar.
If you would but take the field, their bellies would be full by nightfall.
If I take the field, so too will Bahamut, and our duel will shake the island to its foundations. Instead of liberating the Dominion, you would doom it to destruction. Unless that is what you desire.
If our learned advisor has a solution to propose, we should be glad to consider it.
Is that the Emperor's?
What is the meaning of this, Lord Kupka?
What it means is that I am disinclined to advise you any longer. On their faces when you walked through those doors. A perfect picture of stupefaction. They could not believe their eyes. Though I confess, I had my own doubts whether or not you would accept my invitation. Such shocking news. Cid isn't a son of a whore. He's the son of an empress. Your own dear Clive.
Absurd. Who fed you these lies? I have never spent a moment among criminals, save at the gallows. I came here with my son. Not to entertain your baseless accusations, but to put an end to the senseless hostilities between our nations.
Very well. You need only agree to the terms I set out. Cid took the life of someone dear to me, a woman by the name of Benedicta. I swore to take his in turn. This would not be disagreeable to you, I take it. You would finally be rid of the stain on your noble name. In return, I will leave Sanbrek in your capable hands. Your Imperial Majesty.
And all for the love of a common whore. Dominant or no, one cannot hide one's breeding. And beasts will ever belong with beasts. There are greater things in store for you, my darling Olivier. Soon enough, you shall be the crown prince of Sambrec. And when your father goes to meet Great Grieger, you shall be emperor of all you survey. The old order shall come tumbling down, and you will rebuild the world in your glorious image. Soon.
She's been in there for hours. Something must be wrong.